This is Mavulik. She's 5 years old. Mavulik's been unwell for months, and the hospital's doing a blood test to find out what's wrong. Her mother, Melina, is HIV positive, and the doctors think that Mavulik may be positive too. The results will be back in a few hours. Mavulik is being treated here at Chikankata Hospital in southern Zambia. The Salvation Army opened the hospital here in 1945. The hospital serves 85,000 people who live in the surrounding countryside. The lab is about to complete the HIV test on Mavulik's blood. Mavulik is HIV positive, one of the 6,000 people around the world who's infected every day. $25 million people have died from AIDS-related illnesses. 33 million people are today living with HIV and AIDS around the world. But most don't know they have it, and may not know for years until the symptoms show. And in the meantime, they unwittingly put others at risk. There were 2.5 million new infections last year. 3/4 of the people living with HIV and AIDS are in sub-Saharan Africa. Zambia is one of the worst affected countries in the region. Today, 1 in 5 of the population is living with HIV. Chikankata has a long history of treating people with the disease. By the mid-1990s, the numbers of people who were dying from AIDS reached epidemic proportions. Salvation Army officers Dean and Iowin Pallant were based here at that time. Iowin worked as a doctor.
People were dying all the time. I was forever writing out death certificates. 99% of them were for people younger than myself. I was devastated. It affected everyone. There was nobody who was immune.
HIV is known mostly as a sexually transmitted disease, but it's also passed on by drug users sharing needles and through unscreened blood transfusions. A mother who is HIV positive can pass the disease on to her child during pregnancy, in childbirth, or through breastfeeding.
A lot of the diseases here are related to HIV, like maybe 70-80% of them. If you see that a child is taking so long to recover from a simple diarrhea, you suspect. So like if I don't know the status of the mums, I usually try to encourage them to get tested so that we know what we're dealing with.
The children are perhaps some of the most tragic victims of HIV. And so it's a specific target group to try and reach the pregnant mums, persuade them to be tested, to be put on treatment, to reduce the transmission to the children.
In 1996, new drugs called antiretrovirals, or ARVs, became available, but they were too expensive for developing countries. After 5 years of legal battles with the pharmaceutical companies, prices began to fall, and affordable drugs started to become available, but there's still a long way to go. Only 1/3 of the 6 million people in developing countries who need ARVs get access to them.
Number 2, number 3.
Patients at Chikankata are some of the lucky ones. The hospital now distributes ARVs to a growing number of patients. The manager of the community health and development team at the hospital is Charles Mangombe.
Actually, in the early days, when you were diagnosed, you were tested and you are HIV positive. I mean, there was no hope because there was nothing you could look at that would solve the problem. But I think with the introduction of ARVs, we are seeing a lot of hope because we are seeing people who are bedridden, working, and are economically viable again. And so this is the value that ARVs has added to the general population.
The provision of antiretrovirals has made a massive difference. It stops the virus multiplying, and therefore it slows the progression of the disease down, and people are now living 20, 30 years with the disease. That doesn't mean that people do not still become ill and die with HIV. So there is still need for care teams for those who are sick.
Alongside the role of treating those who already have the disease, the Salvation Army has put a lot of effort into prevention work, both in places where it's really taken hold and in parts of the world where HIV has yet to make an impact.